Humanity, one of Earth's most well-known group of animals, is famous for their affinity for religion. Real big fans of religion, those guys. But what you might not know is that humans aren't alone in this. In fact, there are plenty of other animals that are believed to believe. In religion, that is. One such example is the chimpanzee. Some of their religion-y aspects are seen by them doing stuff like showing moral agency, having symbolic capacity, blah blah blah, but it's also seen in some wacky stuff that they do. Like, sometimes chimps will find a hollow tree and just start throwing rocks at it. Maybe they'll make a whole rock pile at its base, or if they're feeling a little spicy, fill the whole darn thing with rocks. This doesn't get them any food, and it's not like the males do it to show the females, hey lady, look how good I am at throwing rocks. So they don't get mates out of it either. The really interesting thing is that those rock piles I was talking about look really similar to cairns, which are big, man-made, ceremonial rock piles that are just dotted all over the place. It's also the name of a dog breed, but that's not as important. Another interesting thing is that this isn't a one-time thing. There are other ceremonies too. Like a little dance that they'll do in the rain or around waterfalls, and another they use to ward off raging bushfires, which I feel may have varied results. Though, to be fair, from what people have seen, it doesn't seem like the chimps actually fear the bushfires and will often monitor them, like, just as I expected, it's hot. And apparently they've gotten pretty good at it, since there have been occasions where the chimps are able to more accurately predict the movements of the fire than the scientists watching them. So I don't know if that's a compliment to the chimps or an insult to the scientists, but either way, it's something. But enough about chimps, let's talk about elephants. One old Roman guy called Pliny the Elder, who I'll probably talk about more in the future, thought very highly of elephants, saying that their intelligence is more comparable to people's than any other animal, that they can give and follow orders, and that they possess higher notions of honesty than most men. So yeah, he liked them. And according to him, they also had that moral agency thing that I was talking about earlier with the chimps. There's also some evidence that they worship the moon, since whenever it's full, they'll stop doing whatever it was they were doing and start waving sticks in the air toward it. And if they're near a body of water, like a lake or a pond, they'll splash the matriarch with trunkfuls of water for some reason. Elephants are also much less likely to raid villages for crops and the like if the full moon is out. So call me crazy, but maybe they don't want their moon god to see them doing bad things, or else their elephant souls will be damned to elephant hell for the rest of time. A place where all the supermarkets are always out of peanuts. Or maybe the villagers are just more likely to see them coming when it's lighter outside. I don't know. But even that is kind of impressive, honestly. Just being able to see a correlation between the phase of the moon and how successful a raid would be is kind of wild. They're also one of the only animals that bury their dead, which is fairly well known. But it's not just their dead that they bury. There have been accounts of elephants burying rhinos, cows, and calves, and even one sighting of a human body being buried by them. These burials are no, let's just throw them in some hole so they stop sinking up the place either. They're a whole deal. They'll cover the body in branches, place flowers around it, and seem to even try to move it into a fetal position. But it's kind of hard to tell since they're not very good at it on account of the whole elephant thing. But they do reposition the body, which is the important detail. What's really cool is that this has a lot of similarities to how some people believe Neanderthals would bury their dead. Other animals, like ravens, have also been seen mourning the death of others. If part of a raven's unkindness dies, then they'll just hang out around the body for a while, circling over it and then carrying on. This isn't quite the same as decorating their graves with flowers, but it's still interesting. Of course, a lot of this could be explained with stuff other than just proto-religious beliefs, like the chimp log thing could possibly just be a way to mark the chimp's territory or something. And the whole bushfire deal could just be the chimps beginning to learn how to obtain the power of fire, but it's still interesting to think that maybe they are religious. Also, the elephant stuff seems pretty legit to me, but hey, what do I know? Anyway, like and subscribe, or else the elephant moon god will damn your soul to an eternity without Pan-Asian supermarkets. You have been warned. But until next time, don't die. Sayonara.
There are no Pan-Asian supermarkets now in hell, so you can't buy Golden Boy peanuts. There are no Pan-Asian supermarkets down in hell, so you can't buy